Well, Clint Eastwood is one of a handful of extraordinary actors to have found success in front and behind the camera. His first time as a director was for the 1971 thriller Play Misty For Me, and he followed up with a host of Oscar-winning films. Now, Clint's latest film is about to hit the cinemas, and it marks his return to both directing and starring in one of his own films in 10 years. Our very own Ange Bishop sat down with the Hollywood legend for this Australian television exclusive.
I have been an entertainment reporter for 24 years, yet this is my first time interviewing you. Are you new?
Am I new here?
Yeah, are you new in town? You're new in Hollywood?
That's kind of an opening line you use at a bar. Often?
Have you been waiting as long as me to be
here? Yes, I have.
Why do you keep we women waiting this long? Have you kept any souvenirs from your films over the years? Do you have, for instance, the car from Gran Torino, Dirty Harry's gun, the man with no name's poncho, the boots from Unforgiven? Do you have any of these things?
I have all those things.
You have all of those things?
Yeah, I do.
Where are they?
They're in various places. They're hidden.
You're not going to give me the direct address now. Can't trust those Australians. We're still convicts.
No, I mean, the funny thing is about the poncho, there was only one. When you start a film, you make triplicates of everything so that if you lose it. So it was so bad, and we were shooting in Spain, and they were losing everything anyway. And so I thought, I better take this stuff home. So I had to go home at night with all my hat, my gun belt, guns,
I love it.
Everything.
All your props and costumes to keep them together.
Go to the hotel, and I'd lock it in the closet in the hotel, and then the next morning, take it all with me. Because I just figured somebody's going to lose it, and at the end you get kind of attached to it. Maybe it's time to let
the old ways down. Bradley Cooper is someone you have worked with before, and you guys have an affinity. He's a bit busy at the moment doing the Star Is Born thing. There was some talk you were going to direct that. Have you seen it? Do you think he did a good job?
Yeah, I think he did a great job. I have seen it. And I did flirt with it for a while, but various things came up that caused the project not to go ahead. He stepped in, had an idea, and it was a good idea, and he's made a good picture out of it, so it's perfect.
Holy. Need help, sir?
Oh, officer, hi.
You need help?
No, I'm fine, thank you.
So what was it like to watch your father take on that mantle of this rather eccentric character?
I was really surprised that he was doing this film, actually, because he's somebody who absolutely hates drugs and doesn't really, he'll have a beer or something, but he's very anti that sort of thing. He's not from the 60s, he's older than that, so he didn't go through that whole hippie, dope smoking, taking acid thing, you know? Both of my parents are so straight-laced. And so I was really surprised that he was going to play somebody that was going to be driving around with a bunch of blow in the back of his truck. But, it's obviously not just about that. It's really about him, his character and what the choices that he makes and how he gets himself into this conundrum. But, I found it really surprising that he chose this,
I didn't deserve forgiveness. This is the last one.
Do you think we'll see him on the screen one more time?
I don't know. I'm not sure. It just depends. I think at this point, he's doing it only when he finds something he thinks he's really right for. I mean, there's not too many roles out there for men in their late 80s that are pretty deep and interesting and complex. So if somebody writes something out there, I'm sure he might be into it, but I know that, it's got to be really sort of specific to where he's at. Many moons I have lived,
my body's withered and worn. The song at the end over the credits, beautiful, Don't Let the Old Man In, made me think you haven't let the old man in and that chances are you've got another 3 or 4 projects ready to go. Is that true?
No, I don't really. I've been looking at stuff and I keep reading material, but I did mention to Toby Keith that we were talking one day playing golf and we were talking about what's the secret in life, and I said is never let the old man in. And he says, God, that's a great title. And he walked up, and he wrote a song about it. So we put it in the end of the movie.
Never let the old man in. And as we mentioned earlier, this has been a lifelong career dream for you. What was he like to sit down and chat with, and what do you think makes him such an extraordinary talent?
He's utterly professional, I think, is the first and foremost thing. So we mentioned he's directed 37 films. Every single one of them has come in on time, and a whole lot of them under budget. A bunch of them have won Oscars, including Unforgiven and Million Dollar Baby.
Yep.
Which also won an Oscar for the actress Hilary Swank. He was making movies with female leads way before anyone else was, you know. But so he comes into the ring, he knows what he wants, he knows what he's got to do. He does very few interviews because he just doesn't have to. So he picks and chooses who he's going to do them with. He wants to tell you about the film, but he wants to tell you about himself too. And I was lucky enough to get a tiny slice of that, which was absolutely fantastic.
I thought it was extraordinary. I thought you got two really good things. Like, I think that were hinting to you that this could be the last hurrah.
Yeah,
it seemed to suggest
that,
you know, sure, never say never, but...
He says he's still looking, but
yeah, of course he would. But I'm counting that as an exclusive. So there you go. You saw it here first. This could be Clint's last film. And also, you got his daughter, I think, to touch on the fact that he never goes with the cliche, and he always goes against almost his own type. So even though he's a conservative in Hollywood, a Republican in Hollywood, which is probably the loneliest place on earth, he takes all these roles of a drug smuggler, even though he hates drugs. So he's always acting against his own type. He's always doing something
exactly
that challenges
going out.
Himself.
And getting the team. So he's got Bradley Cooper's in this film as well. So that's why I brought Bradley
into it. I saw Bradley in the back.
Yeah, that's right. He's plays the police. So it's a true story of this 90-year-old man who smuggled hundreds and hundreds of kilos of cocaine to the Mexican drug cartels across the United States. But the film's actually very funny in parts too, I have to explain, because, of course, any 90-year-old man smuggling cocaine across the States is probably an eccentric character.
Indeed.
He actually is. And so Andy Garcia's also in it. Mm-hmm. It's a ripper of the film. He's released it very late into the awards season, so we haven't seen it feature among nominations yet, but there's a lot of talk it could feature in the Oscar nominations yet again. So it's out in Australia on January 24th. But, thanks, Clint. You made my day.